Chapter 471, A Competition? Why are there so many Zerg? Looking at his base that had been swallowed by the sea of Zerg, Gatina's expression was hard to describe. More importantly, a large group of people had been watching his defeat after he became the commander of the powerful Protoss for less than 20 minutes. He had just gotten out of the base, but he was already buried by the ocean-like Zerg. How come I only got zealots and dragoons? But they already developed to this stage. His mind lingered at the moment when the base exploded. His old face turned dark. Their Zerg looks powerful. A few men from the demon clan scratched their hairy heads and said, Humphrey, their Zerg are ugly and disgusting. Mew King said with a snort, who would choose to play them? Dot. Junior Sister Mew, you're right, Xuanhuan said, Senior Gu was only careless. After all, their Zerg are no match for the Protoss. This time, Gatinian chose only three Zerg as his enemies and then got busy with building the gateway. About a dozen minutes later, a sea of Zerg swarmed up. So many of them again? The audience felt sick as their faces almost turned green. Gatinian decreased the number of enemies to one. One versus one battle. I don't believe it. 3 minutes later, waves of Zerglings swarmed into the Protoss base. Meanwhile, the few zealots in Gatinian's base watched the waves of Zerglings in a daze. Dot. The audience fell silent. Their Zerg are so powerful. Gatinian quickly changed his race to play Zerg. Many people returned to their seats and chose to play Zerg as well. Then, their six Zerglings were killed by three zealots, and a team of Zerglings was killed by six zealots. After being killed many times, they finally discovered the truth. None of the races was stronger than the other. It was possibly because they couldn't defeat the computer. After being tortured by the computer for a while, someone finally complained to the shop owner. Pointing at his computer, Xuanhuan yelled, Sir, how come the computer is so powerful? Is it powerful? Mr. Fang looked nonplussed. Although the players couldn't set the degree of difficulty for the computer bots, it should only be a little more intelligent than the bots that he had played against before he traveled through space and time. It wasn't as dumb as before in some areas. For example, in the original version, when a player sent two base units like SEVs to lure base units from the bots, the latter would all follow out like morons, which made the 1 versus 7 match a piece of cake. How can you say it's not difficult? Mew King seconded Xuanhuan while eating spicy sticks. She glanced at Mr. Fang's screen and saw that he was still playing the campaign mode. Why don't you try it? Mr. Fang said in disdain. Why should I? He continued with the campaign mode. Is it possible that the boss doesn't know how to play this mode? Jiangxi Oyu leaned over curiously. After all, the shop owner would have shown off his skills whenever he was given the opportunity. This wasn't his style. Impossible. I just don't want to lower myself to be on the same level as these people who couldn't even defeat bots, Mr. Fang said while staring at the screen. He discovered that when he played the campaign mode from the RPG angle, it felt like playing Resident Evil. Occasionally, the players were allowed to drive vultures or other battle vehicles and could even operate the wraiths and star cruisers from the first-person perspective. It was much more interesting compared to the campaign mode in the original version. More importantly, he would soon meet the Queen of Blades. Although the Queen of Blades was now still a human, Mr. Fang was still pleased that he could see her. What do you mean by lower yourself? The people who had complained about the difficulty of the game were not happy. Right. How could he say that? I'm sure he can't beat the computer either. He doesn't dare to try it. Mr. Fang. Meanwhile, an old laughter came. I finally defeated them. Look, Senior Gu has defeated the computer. So soon? Wangxi looked over in surprise. Sure enough, a victory icon appeared on the screen. Of course, Gatinian said with confidence. This game is good. You have to control all your resources carefully and have a clear understanding of your resources and troops. The most important thing is that you must multitask. Gatinian shared his experience. In this battle, I directed the ground troop to guard the entrance to the valley with the defense arrays. On the other hand, I sent out small teams of soldiers to harass the enemies in transportation spiritual boats under my personal control. taking advantage of their lack of air control methods. Meanwhile, I developed my force at top speed. By working three lines at the same time, I took their base without a sweat. Excellent. Zong Wu praised gustily, Senior, that is an amazing strategy that you thought of yourself. The senior daughter is in Heavenly Academy. He excels in making strategies. I heard that Senior Gu is one of the best chess players in the world. This strategy was easy for him. The shop owner is indeed good, but old people are more experienced in this field of making strategies. The people talked among themselves while nodding. At this moment, the players of the other two shops were mostly playing the campaign mode. Meanwhile, Mr. Fang was still calmly playing the campaign mode. I'm sure that the scummy shop owner doesn't know how to play multiplayer mode. After staying in the group chat for a long while, some people began to call him scummy shop owner as well. Otherwise, he wouldn't keep playing campaign mode all the time. After all, in the campaign mode, the players could use their own cultivation strength to their advantage. Look, Senior Gu destroyed the Protoss with Zerg. He's indeed a shrewd man, sir. In fact, Mu King had been reluctant to accept Mr. Fang's title as the president of Heavenly Fang Online Games Guild. Even the little princess of Jiang family calls him boss, which means that as Jiangxi Oyu's good friends are one level lower than him too. At this moment, she said gloatingly, didn't you say that you didn't want to lower yourself to play with people who couldn't defeat the computer? Now that Senior Gu has won against several computers, maybe it's time for you to show your hand, little king. Bei Ai tugged at her clothes, feeling a headache since she knew that this girl was trying to make trouble again. Yeah, sir, it's time for you to try it, right? Others seconded her and shouted, obviously not believing that Mr. Fang, a young man, could be more experienced in leading troops and making strategies than the experienced old men. After all, this wasn't a game that one could win with small tricks, it was a battle of strategies. Helpless, Mr. Fang could only look at Gatinion. At this moment, battling with the computers obviously couldn't satisfy Gatinion. He stroked his beard and suggested, shall we have a match? Chapter 472, there is such a strategy, a match. Mr. Fang glanced at his own screen. Are you sure it's a good idea? Why not? Xuanhuan said immediately, we want to watch your sophisticated strategies. Don't you agree, guys? Hearing these words, Mr. Fang knew that it was impossible to decline. So, he nodded and said, okay, I'll have a match. Not daring to be careless, Gatinian chose the Protoss that he was the most familiar with. Let's see what race Mr. Fang will choose. After seeing Gatinian choose the Protoss, the audience walked over and watched Mr. Fang. Mr. Fang's cursor hovered on the races in hesitation and then clicked on random. Huh? Question mark. How come the shop owner chose random? He is too arrogant and underestimated his opponent, Zemo said with a snort. Does he think that he will defeat Master's Protoss army with a random race? After all, it was a match of commanding skills and strategies, not The Legend of Sword and Fairy 3. In The Legend of Sword and Fairy 3, one could defeat Chong Lu with all kinds of items, but this game focused on strategies. This wasn't a strong area for young people. The shop owner didn't look old, and it wasn't easy for old cultivators to act young. One still could see their true age through their manners and ways of doing things. In his opinion, the ability to make good decisions and create proper strategies needed time to polish. Maybe the shop owner thinks that it doesn't matter which race he chooses since he is bad at this game anyway. Ha 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 ha. Mu King convulsed with laughter. He can't be so weak and lame. Jiangxi Oyu leaned toward Mr. Fang. Boss, can you do it? I found the old academy principal has excellent commanding skills. Of course, Mr. Fang answered casually. Don't worry, I can easily defeat seven computers at the same time. Humphrey, you're bluffing. Now, even Jiangxi Oyu didn't believe him. Even if the senior gave you private lessons, you can't boast like this. Meanwhile, the game started. It was a rocky wilderness in a medium-sized map. The moment that he entered the game, Gatinian got busy developing his force. On Mr. Fang's side dash, standing behind Mr. Fang, some young guys exclaimed, Protoss as well? They were surprised that random also give Mr. Fang Protoss. It's not good for the opponent to know about your ace, right? Li Yuya said from the side. The random choice can confuse the opponent, but you guys just told everyone the result, eh? Gatinian looked back in displeasure and said, keep quiet, just like you are watching a chess match. However, Mr. Fang didn't show any intention to restart the game. He continued to make probes. Then, he sent out a probe to scout, which wasn't an unusual move. At this moment, most of the audience turned their attention to Gatinian's operations. He built a gateway first. It seems that Senior Gu wants to test the water with an attack. It looks like it. Gatinian had just trained one zealot when Mr. Fang's probe trotted in. It strolled past the zealot as if it were in its own base. Then, it ambled to one of Gatinian's probes which was working and shot the latter with its particle beam. The tiny particle beam shot on the probe's energy shield, creating a streak of pale blue light. It didn't inflict much damage except consuming some energy of the shield, but its behavior was so arrogant. Is it here to be killed? Doesn't he know that his rival has trained a zealot? Provocation. This is blatant provocation. Gatinian didn't say anything, but the young people behind him rolled up their sleeves indignantly, wishing that they could go up and kill the provocative probe. It was outrageous. Gatinian was calm since he had trained two zealots by now. It was a piece of cake to kill a probe. However, when the two zealots started moving toward it, the probe turned and ran at top speed with a sway of its butt. It's good that it knows who's more powerful. Zumo nodded and said, it seems that this probe knows the great power of zealots. The moment he said it, Mr. Fang's probe turned back around and continued to fire at Gatinian's probe. Damn it. The two zealots followed up again. This time, they didn't plan to let this unit of Mr. Fang go. They surrounded the probe from both sides. Mr. Fang's probe moved to the left for a while before turning a big circle and running out. It dashed out from the gap between the two zealots. It is about to get away again. By now, the gateway had trained another zealot. This zealot exerted force and dashed toward Fang Chi's probe at a faster speed. With the new operations, the players had more accurate control of the Shinnik power in the Protoss units if they could operate them in person. Mr. Fang's probe moved in a fancy and dashing fashion, swaying its butt. Ding! Two Psi blades struck on the tail wing of the probe. The light shield disappeared, which showed that the damage was high. Then, the audience watched as Mr. Fang dragged the injured probe away. Humphrey, what was the use of harassing with this probe? Xuanhuan said in disdain. It scrambled away after zealots showed their hands. If it is a distraction designed to pull the enemy away from their base, it isn't a good one. Wangxi commented. Right. Zongwu nodded and said, now, Senior Ge can send zealots to harass his opponent base. After all, the zealots were not like probes which had little damage. At this moment, someone glanced at Mr. Fang's base and saw no offensive buildings and not even a defense tower. Look at the shop owner's base. He hasn't even built the gateway yet. He was busy directing the probe to harass and forgot to build his base. Ha ha ha. Now that the zealots are going over, his base will be destroyed. Academy Master Ge's four zealots are going there. The shop owner is placing photon cannons. It's too late, no? Xuanhuan said contemptuously. He doesn't have any soldiers. What's the use of building cannons now? How can he fight? Senior Ge's zealots are turning back. Gatinian's zealots had covered half of the distance between the two bases when they suddenly turned back. Mr. Fang cancelled the building of the photon cannon. How come Senior Ge's base is on fire? Mu King exclaimed while pointing at the screen. They glanced up and almost spat blood on the screen. On the right top corner behind an inconspicuous hill, Mr. Fang's photon cannon appeared out of the blue and began firing at Gatinian's probes and base. Some probes that came out of nowhere were still busying building more photon cannons. Exclamation mark. No one had noticed this place. The two newly trained zealots hurried up to help. Before they could get close, they felt a sense of dizziness when they saw another two photon cannons hiding behind the concealed location of the first one. Boom, boom. One zealot was dead. Not only Gatinian, but the players watching from behind felt as if they would spit out blood as well. Damn it. What kind of strategy is this? Chapter 473. An honorable match. In the final phase and the hardest part of a chess game, there were some special moves for special situations, and one couldn't lose if they followed the steps in the chess book. In StarCraft, there were some strategies and certain moves similar to the ones recorded in the chess book. For example, Mr. Fang used this move of photon cannons, which was a killing move against new players. However, it didn't mean that the old players wouldn't be fooled. To trick the old players, one had to have a great understanding of psychology and some luck. In fact, everyone fooled by this move would instantly doubt their own intelligence since this strategy looked so dumb. However, except for the supermasters, there were so many people, new and old players, who fell for this trap that they could form a line around Earth. In terms of the game, players didn't find it easier to play when it was more real. In the original version, one could find out from the red marks on the map if there were enemies. But now they could only see the surrounding area from the mental images transferred among different individual Protoss units, besides the bird view map of the area around the base and the camera surveillance on the buildings. On one hand, there wasn't the fog of war anymore, but on the other hand, vision didn't become more convenient. Mr. Fang's probe entered his rival's base not only to provoke but to distract the audience and the enemy's Protoss force. Meanwhile, he built photon cannons in the blind spot. When Gatinian withdrew the force from the outside, Fang Chi had almost finished building the fourth photon cannon. The four photon cannons were planted near Gatinian's base like a malignant tumor. If they were not destroyed, Gatinian couldn't even send his probes to extract minerals. However, even if he sent out his force, they were lowest level Protoss units as their attack damage and defenses weren't upgraded. Regardless of how good Gatinian's operations were, they were no match for the defense towers. Fang Chi killed all the zealots and lost only one photon cannon. While his photon cannons fired at Gatinian's probes, Mr. Fang built another photon cannon right beside Gatinian's base. The audience watching from behind all turned red with pent-up rage. They felt like dying and taking Mr. Fang along. Gatinian took off his virtual reality headset and quitted the game. GG. If he were another person, he would have jumped up and hit Mr. Fang with a chair. Mr. Fang put down his virtual reality headset and turned his head, and he saw a group of people glaring at him with green eyes. They were indignant. How can he be so cunning? It wasn't a fair match. Not fair at all. Zumo yelled in disapproval. It was a win by playing tricks. One must move steadily in a real war. How could you use such a trick at the beginning of the game? Right. If it were a real war, it would be suicidal to build nothing in your own base. If anything went wrong, you would have been defeated easily, Xuanhuan said. The audience had noticed that Mr. Fang had no defense towers or and no soldiers. With only probes, his base could be destroyed by a handful of enemies. How can anyone command a war like this? If the ancient families had done things this way, they would have been destroyed long ago. I think you should have another match, Mu King said while eating spicy sticks. I think so too. One more match. Many people seconded her opinion. Gatina said, shall we have another match? At everyone's urging, they started another match since it was in high demand. This time, Gatinian kept an eye on Mr. Fang's tricks. He chose the map in which he had played the first 1v7 game as Protoss. His base was in a valley with one opening, and he blocked the entrance with a photon cannon, so no one could enter under the monitoring of the defense tower. Mr. Fang's SEVs ventured to his opponent's gate and returned when he found that his opponent was building a photon cannon. After all, one must have the opportunity to use the rush strategy. If there were no opportunity, they must give it up as it would be meaningless since it wouldn't succeed. In this match, Mr. Fang used the standard moves and commands and exchanged several rounds of attacks with his opponent. Despite Mr. Fang's good skills, he didn't want to compete with a grandmaster on micromanagement. After all, grandmasters were fast learners, And these operations were not difficult for them. A Protoss commander could control a portion of the soldiers with the Shinnok link, personally like controlling several doppelgangers. Mr. Fang's opponent wasn't an ordinary player but a super grand cultivator with extremely high cultivation strength, with great micromanagement. He could even control three zealots simultaneously to hack bullets with blades. These scenes were thrilling to look both in terms of visual effect and skills. The operations were almost impeccable. This time, the random option gave Mr. Fang the race of Terrans, which was a race that Gatinian had not fought with before. Despite all that, Mr. Fang kept a steady pace with his moves. 20 minutes later, dash. I told you that the shop owner is not good at this. Look at Senior's base. Such a huge battleship. So many strange spiritual boats. Then, they looked at Mr. Fang's home base. There are so few spiritual ships in the shop owner's base. Academy Master Gu is on the offense. Gatinian's screen was filled with all kinds of battleships, which showed a strong economy. In contrast, Mr. Fang still had a mixture of air and ground forces, if not mentioning the mix of forces. He had even launched a sneak attack when his opponent was out on the attack. In the end, he caused little damage to his opponent but lost all his soldiers. What was stranger, they were puzzled that Mr. Fang had even brought a dropship for transportation in his sneak attack. This ship exploded before it could drop any soldiers. I'm sure that the shop owner is going to lose. Seeing Gatinian leading the huge army of battleships to attack his enemy, the audience chattered in excitement. Escorted by all kinds of flying spiritual artifacts, the golden battleships lined up like a wave of golden clouds, blocking out the sun. When a huge golden spiritual ship flew up slowly, and then the light surrounding it distorted, as if they were concealed by an intangible sky curtain, all the Protoss battleships turned invisible. The yellow sand swept across the desolate wasteland, and the golden arbiter flew across the sky like a swallow-shaped shadow when one looked up. Only on Gatinian's screen could the audience see the massive number of battleships. The huge group of battleships attacked from one side of Fang Chi's base. The interceptors flying out from the huge battleships swarmed up like locusts. In the blink of an eye, most of the buildings in Fang Chi's second base were destroyed, including the reinforcements. They swept toward the heart of the base with tremendous force. Chapter 474, Is this why you call the shop owner scum? The shop owner is going to lose for sure. Ha 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 ha. Excellent. Excellent. Zemo said while laughing, this group of spiritual ships is super powerful. Nodding, Zongwu said, in the last match, the shop owner caught us by surprise, but tricks can't help him go far. More importantly, they had been feeling so indignant watching the last match that they felt exhilarated to see that Mr. Fang was finally at a disadvantage. However, they saw a strange arrow-shaped spiritual artifact slowly rising from the second base. It shot up into the sky with a long tail of flames like a shooting star. In the next moment, Gatinian, who was sitting in the command station, suddenly turned his head and looked out of the window. He saw an object landed with a long tail of flames. It landed right in the center of the buildings around the base. Next, the audience felt as if their eyes were going to pop out when they saw a huge mushroom-shaped cloud rising into the air with earth-shaking noises. Then, everything in sight, including the spiritual ships and buildings, was shattered into pieces by a horrifying force. A destructive blast instantly radiated out, and the shields outside the base were torn into pieces like paper. Then, the metal armor of the base melted and shattered into dust. The audience reached out their heads and watched the scene in terror. What's this? When they recovered their eyesights, which had been blinded by the dazzling light, they found that the heart of the base had become a ruin. Only a few buildings in the outer range remained standing. The audience felt like their minds turned blank at this scene. The thing came from the shop owner's base. They had clearly seen something fly out of his base. Destroy this base, the audience yelled, looking more impatient than Gatinian. At this moment, in Mr. Fang's commander center, a strange ball slowly floated after some battle cruisers. Meanwhile, Mr. Fang's hands moved so swiftly that it looked like he was having a stroke. A violent shaking spread out from the Protoss battleships. Almost instantly, The EMP shockwave from the science vessel paralyzed most of the Shinnik shields of the Protoss army. A strange ripple swept across the Protoss battleships. Scanner sweep. All the invisible units were revealed. My goodness. Look at Mr. Fang's screen. People saw Mr. Fang directing the battle cruisers and the wraiths to cover others while he himself controlled two wraiths to fly into the core of the Protoss battleship fleet in an elegant arc while bullets shot around them. Boom, boom, boom. In the smoke, the Protoss observer which could detect invisible units was found out and destroyed. When the damaged wraiths' aircrafts returned from battle, another two wraiths flew out and destroyed another observer together with the other aircraft. On the screen, Mr. Fang swiftly switched screens, drove the aircrafts, and issued orders all at the same time. Now the wraiths turned invisible, and the Protoss couldn't detect their whereabouts. Like ghosts, the wraiths attacked the carrier that no longer had the protection of energy shields. When the battle cruisers fired, the carriers tried to flee, but they suddenly were frozen in midair. They were locked by ghosts. Mr. Fang had moved them up without alerting his enemies. Pull over more troops. Steady. The Protoss base, which had been razed to the ground, was in reconstruction. It was lucky that the nuclear missile didn't have radiation. Otherwise, the whole base would have become a wasteland. At this moment, several Banshee aircraft flew into Gatinian's base and directly fired at the Nexus even though it was still warping in. Gatinian was livid with fury, and his face almost turned green. Can't you wait until I rebuild the base? In the second base, a row of dropships flew in, and then tanks formed a line while many Marines gathered. The Marines instantly started firing, the ends of their guns looking like a long dragon of flames. Meanwhile, tanks were moving in from the front. The Protoss's main force was forced to retreat, and the newly formed military force was instantly scattered by the Terran forces that were coming from all sides. The Protoss force couldn't put up a defense. Oh my goodness. The audience watching in the back gasped. It was obvious that the Protoss's military force was more powerful. But at Mr. Fang's command, the human units worked together seamlessly. The aircraft that he personally controlled pierced into the heart of the enemy like a sharp blade. The machines followed Mr. Fang's swift orders completely, moving at a dizzying fast speed without losing formation. They attacked the three Protoss bases from six directions, and the survivors of the Protoss main force fled back with more than half of its soldiers lost. Ah! Mu King yelled while pointing at the screen. How can the shop owner command so well? Doesn't everyone call him the scummy shop owner? The few girls looked incredulous. Zemo gazed at the screen in a daze. It shouldn't have ended like this. Zongwu craned his neck as if he wished to dig into the screen. With ashen faces, Xuanhuan and the others stared at Gatinian's screen, which was filled with flying spiritual artifacts and Terran troops that were raising everywhere. The Protoss had been in the advantage, but the tables were turned when a horrible mushroom-shaped cloud rose into the sky. What the heck was that? What was the thing that had instantly got rid of all the shields on the Protoss battleships? The war scenes were so magnificent and real in the virtual reality that the audience was awestruck even though they watched the scenes merely through the screen. Displeased, Mu King asked in the group chat in QQ, "Didn't you guys always say the shop owner is scum and trash? How come he's so powerful?" The people in the group chat always called him scum and trash. She just couldn't believe what she had just seen. He had defeated Chong Lu with dirty tricks. Then how come he became so powerful all of a sudden? Nal and Minxu sent three question marks. The shop owner has always been powerful. Then, why do you call him scum and trash? Yuninian replied, "We say it to vent our frustration since we can't defeat him." Nal and Hongwu chimed in, "Wait, don't tell me that you guys went to mess with him." The cultivators in Yuan Yang City read the messages in the group. Xuanhuan replied, "Wangxi send." Zongwu added, "Gatinian exited the game and glared at the messages in the group chat. This is why you call him scummy shop owner and trash every day?" Tang Yu followed up, "Damn it. Why are you only telling the truth after he tortured us like this?" Chapter 475, We live on a star as well? Mr. Fang suddenly found that people were staring at him with weird looks on their faces. Why are you staring at me? Mr. Fang touched his face. Do I have flowers on my face? The others were speechless. Pooh, scummy shopona. Mew King mumbled and turned back to her game. The others who had wanted to watch the shop owner's defeat looked embarrassed. They were not on the same level as Mr. Fang. Obviously, Mr. Fang had reached quite a high level in the understanding of different strategies and making the different units work in harmony while they were still at the stage of simply moving armies. He's really good. Xuanhuan was amazed to find that the young shop owner had such a good understanding of strategies. Boss, how come you're all so good at this game? Jiangxi Ouyu stared at his screen curiously with wide open eyes. Boss, what were those things that you just used? They are indeed powerful. She had seen that there were many spiritual ships parked in Gatinian's base after the carriers were sent out to attack. However, these ships were all destroyed by Mr. Fang's bomb, which also left a terrifying crater in the ground. That weapon was indeed powerful. Li Lanyuo still looked fearful when she recalled the shocking sight of the mushroom cloud and the power which shattered everything in one instant. The humans look tiny and fragile, but their spiritual weapons are so powerful. I wonder how they make these spiritual artifacts. It was more than powerful. Its power went beyond their imagination. How could humans are so powerful? Hearing this question, everyone turned to look at him. Mr. Fang didn't know how to answer this question of how to make a nuclear missile. I'm just the owner of an internet cafe. How can I explain this to you? Let's enter the game to find the answer. Tang Yu said. In the other two shops, the customers were mostly playing the campaign mode. Right now, there were no group chats in QQ for StarCraft yet, but someone had created the StarCraft post bar. The new players of this game could open and browse the post bar when they took a break from fighting battles in the campaign mode. Not everyone would play the new games when they just came out. Most of the customers were still playing old games. Only the customers who loved new things or followed the footprints of the shop owner tried StarCraft. However, with the increase of the players in the shops, there were many people playing StarCraft already. They included old players such as Su Danji, Li Haran, Diu An, who was the head artifact master who led the project of the Heavenly Mirror in the Half City Shop, and the disciples of the Nanhua faction. Even Nalan Hongwu, a loyal player of Diablo and the Legend of the Sword and Fairy, had begun playing StarCraft since it was a product of Blizzard. At this moment, Nalan Hongwu had just finished a battle while controlling Reyna in campaign mode. He took a break and opened the post bar. Then, he was startled. There were thousands of replies to posts in the newly established StarCraft post bar. Where is StarCraft happening? Soon, he saw a post that was really popular in the post bar. He opened the post and saw that it was from a girl with ID Sprite. There were many screenshots in the post, including a picture showing the limitless universe with a huge black metal spaceship filling the screen. Above the ship was a dark red planet. The spaceship traveled silently in the void like an island, followed by many small strange-looking bats. Ningbai was reading the many replies to her discussion post. Is this a screenshot of the game? It looks like the starry sky at the beginning of the game. Did you see that there's no land below the ship? The land is the red sphere above the spiritual ship. This land is a sphere? The cultivators in the Jewel City Shop and the Half City Shop had never ventured out of the deserted sea realm, and it was natural that they didn't know the shape of their land. Nalan Hongwu browsed the screenshots and saw that this battleship was flying toward the nearby red sphere. When it got closer, the land looked larger until it became a vast and broad continent. Then, he saw another reply. They, the people in the game, always talk about stars. Could it be that they live on stars? Nalan Hongwu was deep in thought. Sir, do the people in StarCraft really live on stars? Comma with a cup of milk tea in her hand, Ningbai sent a message to Mr. Fang on QQ as if she had discovered a new continent. Stars twinkle, right? How come the stars they live on don't twinkle? Mr. Fang read this message and felt as if he was looking at an elementary schoolgirl in the world where he had lived before his journey to this world. How come you are so naive? The moment that he replied to the message, Another person's icon jumped. Nalan Hongwu asked, "Sir, the people in StarCraft actually live on stars?" Nalan Minxu questioned, "A screenshot of the universe, I feel like these people live on stars. But, do the stars really look like this?" Mr. Fang was at a loss for words. He suddenly found that Ningbai wasn't the only naive person. It seemed like all the people here were naive. They were as curious as children. Jiangxi Ouyu suddenly asked, "How come you're all talking about stars and the people living on stars?" Mu Qing replied, "It's very magical. Living on stars, won't they fall down?" Mr. Fang's face turned dark. "This is magical," Mr. Fang said. "Did it ever occur to you?" He rephrased his words and said, "Maybe, I mean maybe, the land we are standing on is also a star. Have you never thought about it?" "How can it be?" Sitting next to Mr. Fang, Jiangxi Ouyu mumbled to herself, "Boss is trying to fool us again." Mr. Fang's words landed like a bomb and created giant waves, but soon many people expressed their disagreement. Bei Ai said, "If we lived on a star, I would be a fairy, right?" Ningbai added, "I wonder if they are really in the sky, but I do envy them." Su Tanji sent a message in the group chat in QQ while eating instant noodles, "A screenshot of the starry sky. So beautiful." Mu Donglai, "Indeed beautiful. More beautiful than the view that I had seen when standing on the star observing tower." Dot. They had never seen the view of the whole world or the sight beyond the sky, which was probably why they couldn't imagine the view of their planet from space. Chapter 476. Issued arrived from StarCraft. As a person who had traveled through space and time, Mr. Fang took it for granted that the Earth was a sphere in his understanding. However, the people who were born and raised in this world all thought Mr. Fang was wrong, and they completely rejected his suggestion. However, Mr. Fang thought it was meaningless to argue with them. After all, he had even traveled through space and time, and thus he shouldn't be surprised by this, as even stranger things might happen. Of course, Mr. Fang still thought that he was right, since the sun, the moon, and the stars above their heads were not fake. Despite their puzzlement about this problem, the players were enjoying the game greatly. Although the battles in campaign mode usually happened on different planets, they could still appreciate the endless universe during the animations being scenes. "These Zerg units looks powerful." Ningbai posted a picture showing a group of Zerg units catching up with battle cruisers in space. "How do they fly?" "With wings." "Nonsense. This Zerg unit looks like a big crab." "How can it have no wings but still fly?" Mr. Fang replied, "They fly with shinnik power." They talked about these novel things in the group chat from morning to night. For example, they wondered why the universe was always dark and why the people didn't fly during the day. Meanwhile, a group of artifact masters had begun their new research. "Look, isn't it powerful?" Comma in the group chat for artifact masters, Tang Yu posted a picture of a mushroom cloud. "I finally launched it after being killed by the computer many times. How come this power is so great?" "What's this, a new spiritual artifact?" some artifact masters who hadn't seen this scene before asked in surprise. Li Haran said, "Can anyone explain the theory of this? What kind of gunpowder can achieve this effect?" Duan added, "It appears to be more destructive than the explosion of my damn furnace when I tried to make the heavenly mirror." It was well known that the first batch of gunpowder was a byproduct of ancient Taoists trying to make elixir pills, and there were similar things in this world. In most cases, they were treated as failures in the elixir making process. Lan Mo chimed in, "I've thought for a long time and still can't figure out a way to study the mushroom cloud, Taoist friends. I just couldn't understand it." Jun Yang Tsai voiced his opinion, "I think the ghost rifle is more interesting. It uses lightning, which is part of our spiritual spells, right?" "Spiritual spells are our strong suit, no?" Duan Bui typed, "It needs a highly steady source of lightning energy. Not like the spells that we use to shock people for a quick second." Jun Yanzi posted the rough blueprint and the design drawing of a huge crossbow. He said furiously, "Can't we think of a solution to this problem? Even ordinary people could do it. This, I intend to make it into an advanced weapon like the immortal slaying crossbow. This crossbow is quite simple in structure, but we can put other features on it. In fact, Boping's spiritual master was an experienced artifact master. The moment this cultivator joined the group, she heard people talking about this topic. Our Heavenly Academy has a spiritual spell which can transform lightning fire into threads. Maybe we can try it. Good idea. Tang Yu clapped his hands with bright eyes, ignoring the mushroom cloud that he had no clue about how to research. I think we can further simplify the crossbow and attach spiritual spells. Or even better, arrays. Maybe we can get a rough draft first. Good, good. This spiritual artifact would be awesome. I think we can make it more powerful than those in the game. We can make a big one with runes engraved on it and put it on a spiritual ship. Li Haran, good idea. It will be unrivaled. Someone with the ID of spiritual ship expert Gongxiu Qo posted a screenshot of a carrier. Dearest friends, do you think we can make a spiritual ship like this one? This. You can study it at your leisure, brother. Best wishes to you. I hope I can see it before I die. If you succeed, you'll be famous for thousands of years as your name will be recorded into history books. No, for 10,000 years. For the artifact masters, playing games wasn't the only fun thing to do. They also enjoyed studying all kinds of strange spiritual artifacts and discussing their ideas in the group chat. Of course, some people could only play games. For example, Jiangxi Oyu was now driving a vulture vehicle, screaming all the way as she did it. With a dark face, Mr. Fang turned off her external communication. Controlling Kerrigan, Queen of Blades, who was still a ghost agent, Su Tanji was doing well with her excellent shooting skills. She posted a screenshot in the group. The picture showed her leaning on a wall in a deserted human base, while wiping sweat off her forehead. She said, "This battle was hard, but I still got through. Ha ha ha." Husky's laughing face, "Which battle is this?" Su Tanji replied, "The battle in which I was ordered to stall the Protoss army. I did it all by myself." Jiangxi Oyu's smug face with the victory hand. It was an epic victory in which she blocked so many Protoss elite units all by herself. It was a battle that could be recorded in the history. Jiangxi Oyu typed, "Sister Su, how can you steal my personal emoji? Awesome. I haven't reached that part yet." "Magnificent," Su Tanji replied. "It finally ended. I'll take a good break afterwards." In the war among the Terrans, Protoss, and Zerg in StarCraft, each battle was legendary and much more magnificent than those in other games. They were more so in the system version of the game. The humans who were as tiny as ants stood in the huge ruins and looked up at the huge carriers that were blocking the sky, and the groups of Zerg units flew all over the sky in the smoke and devoted themselves in these battles. Even from the perspective of a cultivator, it felt exhilarated to experience such a magnificent battle. As if they were being summoned by something, many Zerg units swarmed up like ocean waves. "Sir, how come my communication is cut off? I was told that I can retreat after the battle, right?" Suddenly, Su Tanji sent a message in the group chat. "The battle that Sister Kerrigan is in? You're finished. You might have been betrayed?" Su Tanji asked. "What?" Putting on the combat goggles, Su Tanji looked forward and saw many Zerg units surging up toward her like ocean waves. There was no exit or reinforcement. She was surrounded by many Zerg units. They were everywhere. It was probably the first time that humans faced a horrifying force like this one. The Sea of Zerg was even more terrifying than heavenly power. The gun slipped down from Su Tanji's fingers when despair swallowed her like cold sea water. At this moment, one could best understand why a human elite would embark on the road of revenge as the Queen of Blades. "F.C.K. I quit," she cussed. Chapter 477, Hand Slipped. "These humans are truly trash." Ning Bai also suddenly posted a screenshot of her being surrounded by Zerg units. Su Tanji asked, "You came to this part as well?" Nalan Ming Su chimed in, I just finished the battle. I can't carry these humans. Xuanhuan typed, have you noticed that most of the people in this game look like the Western barbarians? While people talked about the plot of StarCraft in the group chat, some people had come to the battle which signaled the end of the plot about the Terrans and the beginning of the story about the emergence of the Queen of Blades of the Zerg. In the Yuan Yang City shop, players began the multiplayer mode. On the screen, a 2v2 battle had begun. The two parties were Gatinyon and Wangxi versus Zongwu and Tangyu. A group of people watched the match from behind. This game doesn't only test your strategies and tactics. Watch carefully. Gatinyon looked more experienced after being defeated and tortured by the shop owner several times. On the screen, two Archons, white balls, and four High Templars were attacking Zongwu's Protoss base under the protection of several zealots and dragoons. There was a river that had a width of several dozens of meters before the base, and several photon cannons stood on the bridge. The strong suit of Protoss is splitting the mind and multitasking. The two Archons that he controlled shot apart the light shield of one photon cannon with two sharp Shinnok shockwaves. Then, the four High Templars formed an array as if they knew each other's mind. A Shinnok storm instantly engulfed a large area before them. Meanwhile, something concealed in the darkness moved swiftly in the base, creating violent gales. The Protoss units connect with each other with the Shinnok link, which makes each unit our eyes. The Archon appeared as if it had eyes on the back of its head. It suddenly turned around and shot a huge Shinnok shockwave toward a prior blind spot. A dark shadow flashed, Dark Templar. The saber energies hacking toward the High Templars slipped and shattered the energy shields but missed the High Templars behind. This wasn't lethal. Oh my goodness! The audience exclaimed from behind. Meanwhile, several zealots surrounded them. These newly trained Protoss soldiers only had the lowest level of strength, but when they were controlled by Zongwu, a warrior whose strength was close to the Emperor Warrior Realm, their strength almost reached the hero level. Moving with weird steps, they dodged the surrounding of the enemy units and broke the enemy's energy shields with sharp blades. Immediately, several enemy zealots died under the Psi blades. In the next moment, groups of zealots dashed toward Gatinion's army. At least six of the zealots were much more powerful than the others. One of them even dodged the Shinnok shockwave from an Archon and got close to it. Zongwu said, this game can hone your sense of strategy, but it is also effective and powerful training for your mental energy. The six zealots under Zongwu's control obviously received less damage compared to others while slashing their blades from all kinds of impossible angles. It was a thrilling sight. While controlling the Archons, Gatinyon quickly issued many commands, directing the reinforcements to move the High Templars to another spot by the shuttle aircraft. It was a fast, lightning-like raid. The operations were smoothly done in one breath. Obviously, these grand cultivators were fast learners and had become very strong at least in operations and micromanagement. Even Mr. Fang was surprised while he watched from behind. This old guy can operate so fast after playing only for a short time. How did he do that? Damn. Aren't his hands going to slip? Ouch. My High Templars fell into the river. The swift, stroke-like operations stopped, and he slammed his hand on his thighs while yelling in regret. Dot. The audience watched as the High Templars that fell into the river struggled, and their lips twitched. Gatinyon's old face turned dark. Anyway, this game is very helpful to strengthen your mental energy. Dot. Ha. In his room on the second floor, Mr. Fang stretched while the scene before his eyes changed. Before him stood a young man. He wore a purple gold crown and had a dark purple sword in his hand. He's the Jing Tan who has defeated the evil sword immortal in the second act of The Legend of Sword and Fairy 3. Maybe I can try fighting him. Mr. Fang tightened his grip on his sword while staring at his opponent intently. He could feel his opponent's sharp sword spirit. The sword techniques that Jing Tan used were a little bit rough around the edges, but he moved like a grandmaster. Fang Chi's sword techniques had become even more sophisticated. His style was a mixture of techniques from both the East and the West. The Eastern techniques came from the Xu Mountain faction and Wu Ming's heavenly sword, which were elegant and deep. The Western techniques included Dandi's double-handed sword moves, which were broad yet nimble. The sword energies collided, and they exchanged dozens of attacks in an instant. The mountains on both sides were hacked open, and boulders rolled down with debris. "He's getting stronger and stronger." With a grim expression, Fang Chi continued to block the sword energies that were as swift as lightning flashes. The clouds in the sky dimmed, huge turbid waves surged up. The sky above the shore of the heavenly abyss sea turned from sunny to darkness in the blink of an eye. It seemed like it was another world. Someone seemed to be whispering in the shadows in the sky. "That person that came from the other side of the heavenly abyss sea was found? It is another cycle. Xiaoyu is dead. Does the Jiang family want to touch the forbidden area now? He killed the Nangong family's sword slaves and broke the immortal hacking sword array. The ability to understand the basic laws, the thing that bunch of prisoners have been craving for, might have appeared. Indeed, only with this ability could one instantly kill sword slaves. That person seems to have re-established the connections between the places separated by the heavenly forbidden zones. He did what Xiaoyu had done before. Kill him. We must cut off any connections with the place inside the heavenly forbidden zones. Regardless of how powerful he is, he can't get away from us. No, we don't need to show our hands." The small town on the shore of the heavenly abyss sea was silent. Despite the huge sounds of the surging ocean waves, the people of the town seemed to be in a deep slumber. Right now, two figures standing on the cliff seemed to be whispering to each other about something. "Nangong Lin of the heaven-seeking sword palace is getting more arrogant. After all, those few broken swords in the Nangong family are going to wake up. This is their best opportunity to conquer and unite all seven ancient families. They won't let it pass. Maybe we can nudge them toward it a bit faster." "Good idea." The voices turned faint and distant, and the two figures vanished in the light wind and thin clouds in the sky as if nothing had happened. Chapter 478, can be said as very pleased. Under the leadership of some elders, the Heavenly Academy formed a research group to develop a series of Gauss weapons for cultivators. It was not a big deal to change the shapes of lightning bolts, flames, and other things. In fact, some powerful spiritual spells took the form of dragons, phoenixes, or chirons, not only for good looks. Some auspicious symbols coming from the ancient bloodlines represented a force or a type of control of some energy. One of the inherited spiritual spells in the Heavenly Academy could transform lightning fire into thin threads. It was a method to increase one's control of spiritual spells. The Boping spiritual master had studied this area with her research group formed by disciples for a while now. The moment she logged into QQ, she found that people were talking about this topic in the group chat. Li Heran said, "We have understood a small part of the structure of the gun." In the game, he had disassembled a small part of his gun. On the ground by his feet was loot that he got from the enemy marines. Boping spiritual master replied, "The structure looks simple. It's a metal coil with lightning energy." Li Heran said, "There are some complicated shooting mechanisms, but I think this is the main part." Tang Yu chimed in, "It sounds simple, but when I was trying to mimic it, the bullet got stuck in the coil and wouldn't shoot out. Please tell me where it went wrong. It looks so simple." Boping spiritual master replied, "Really? I thought one coil was enough." "Very naive. When electricity was conducted into the metal coil, the electromagnetic force at both ends would reach the maximum, but the thrust forces were aiming at the opposite direction, which meant that the bullet would be pushed and stuck in the middle. To solve the problem, they had to release the electricity in pulses. These people just put electricity into the coil without thinking, and it was natural that the bullet wouldn't come out. These cultivators obviously knew nothing about theories and thus encountered awkward problems when they mimicked the structures." Li Heran said, "I thought this thing would be super simple. How come the bullets can't shoot out?" Tang Yu seconded that. "Yeah? Could it be that these guns are fake?" Duan refuted, "We even simulated about 30% the power of Heavenly Mirror, and its force was unrivaled." "Don't say things that you don't understand." Since most cultivators knew a little about artifact making, Sometimes the group chat for artifact masters was visited by people not of this profession. Sutanji read the discussions in the group chat and downloaded a copy of the theory behind the use of the spell that could transform lightning fear into threads, which wasn't a confidential document. Sutanji said, "Taoist friends, with our abilities, don't you think that we can use the theory of the ghost guns to make a new spiritual spell? For example, we can discard the spiritual artifact and transform the lightning energy into a coil with our lightning spell. Then, we just put in the bullets. It will be more convenient." Mr. Fang added, "Good idea. Are you going to research it?" Exclamation mark. How come the shop owner slipped into our group? Boping spiritual master was surprised. Even she, a person who has never made artifacts before, could slip in. Why can't I? "Don't forget who taught you the gun-making knowledge." Mr. Fang wiped sweat off his forehead. "Just came out of training, and I'm surprised to find that you are talking about such an interesting topic." Du An replied, "Mr. Fang's everywhere." Boping spiritual master asked, "Do you guys want to research and develop new spiritual spells?" "Indeed, if they were like the ordinary people in the game, studying guns would be more than enough on their plate. However, they were cultivators with extremely high cultivation strengths, and some of them excelled in the lightning spell. Some of them could directly use things and command power that others couldn't even do with the help of spiritual artifacts. Perhaps one day, they didn't have to borrow heavenly power or ancient auspicious symbols in their spiritual spells. They would invent some new and special spiritual spells." Mr. Fang said, "You guys can indeed look into it. I even have a name for this spell." Sutanji quickly chimed in, "I got a name for it too. I think it can be called Danji Godly Lightning." Ning Bai said, "Green Bai Water Godly Lightning sounds better." Li Heran suggested, "Call it Qian Kun Limitless Shocking Thunder Cannon." Mr. Fang was at a loss for words. "I can't find names dumber than these. Can you have a more serious case of 8th grader syndrome?" While people were in heated discussions in the group chats in QQ, several elders gathered in the Heaven-Seeking Sword Palace. The chilly murderous spirit filled the solemn Great Hall. In recent years, the ambitious Heaven-Seeking Sword Palace had restrained their behaviors and kept themselves within the acceptable zone. After all, the other big ancient families were too powerful to be ignored. "What the heck is the background of the shop in Yuanyang City? Have you found it out?" the middle-aged man sitting in the center of the Great Hall asked. His eyes were deep, and profound light flashed in there. "This kid seems to come from the deserted sea realm," a silver-robed old man said. "In normal circumstances, a cultivator from the deserted sea realm can't be so powerful." "Indeed, the cultivators from deserted sea realm can't catch up with us even after 10,000 years. "Do you mean?" the dignified-looking man sitting in the center of the Great Hall said, "This kid got a treasure, something like that, even if it isn't exact." The old man said, "Is good news for our Heaven-Seeking Sword Palace, but—" the middle-aged man said coldly, "I heard that even the old Gatinion is involved with this shop." "HMPH, how much longer can that old guy live?" the old man said with a snort. "When those people of our Heaven-Seeking Sword Palace come out, no one is our match, not the other ancient families or the Heavenly Academy. We have waited for so long." A gloomy growl came from the sword tomb of Heaven-Seeking Sword Palace. It wasn't a human's voice. The sound was deep and metallic, and it felt as if it were resonating in everyone's heart. The disciples of the Nangong family who were guarding the entrance of the sword tomb looked terrified, as if they had seen the most horrifying thing in their lives. "I think," the elder said coldly, "before we conquer the ancient families, we must remove that obstacle and the Heavenly Academy. We can stun the ancient families and show them the great force of our Heaven-Seeking Sword Palace. By then, they will understand the situation and submit to us. Otherwise, we will show them no mercy, and they can't complain about it." Hearing that gloomy sound, the people in the Great Hall looked pleased instead of terrified. "What a surprise. What made them wake up so early?" one elder suggested. "I think we can invite the masters of the big ancient families to watch how we remove these people who overestimate themselves in person." "Right. another elder said fiercely, in the past 1,000 years, no one dared to mess with people of our family. Even the big ancient families must be respectful toward us. Who is this kid? How dare he try to act tough before us? I'll see how he looks when we raise his shop to the ground. When I have the best talent in the younger generations of our family, I'll let these wastrels die with him to keep him company. This is the only way that I can vent my anger. Ha ha ha. Hearty laughter came from the great hall. They were very happy at this prospect. Chapter 479, Prelude. Chilly rain engulfed Xuanyang City, turning the warm weather gloomy all of a sudden. Such bad weather was rarely seen in this ancient city. Raindrops flowed down from the eaves and gathered in the ditches on both sides of the streets before flowing into the man-made canals in the city. A ghost-like figure appeared from nowhere. It stood on the stone bridge while holding a black paper umbrella, watching the rapid currents under the bridge run to the distance while carrying fallen leaves with them. How is the situation in the heaven-seeking sword palace? Don't worry. When those swords come out, even if we don't interfere, they won't stay put. Those guys have always been ambitious. The voice seemed to come from the rapid currents under the bridge or from the gloomy rain that was engulfing the city. The turbid mortal world is like a boat, and the people in it are like tiny weeds that were trying to cross the bitter ocean of life. Only, the cold eyes stared at the fallen leaves and broken branches that were floating in the river as if it were watching everything that was happening in the mortal world with cold eyes. The voice under the umbrella seemed to merge into the rain and gradually faded away. Dot. How come it is raining all of a sudden? Jiangxi Oyu complained when she entered the shop with a small floral umbrella in her hand. It's just rain, Aku. A few other girls came in with her after being released from school. Miu King looked dry even though she didn't hold an umbrella. She suddenly sneezed. How come the rain feels so gloomy today? Get me a cup of milk tea. A new day began from a cup of delicious milk tea. Boss. Instead of playing games, Mr. Fang was sitting on a couch in the lounge area, which was quite unusual. He was probably staring at the sky at a 45-degree angle. Bo.ss. Jiangxi Oyu waved her little white palm before Mr. Fang's face for a while. Ugh. He snapped back. Boss, what were you thinking, staring into the air? Are you worrying about the situation with the Nangong family? Li Lanruo asked in concern. What thing with the Nangong family? Mr. Fang looked nonplussed. After all, the Nangong family had never been disgraced like this. This wasn't a small grudge. It had threatened its reputation as an ancient family. Li Lanruo had been feeling uneasy lately. I'm worried about the quietness. I'm afraid they are making some schemes in the dark. You're right. Miu King, who had been sipping milk tea, heard Li Lanruo's words and said, after all, the heaven-seeking sword palace has always been arrogant and aggressive in the past 1,000 years. They kill others but never allow others to kill their people. Next, Mr. Fang would probably receive a heavy blow from the heaven-seeking sword palace with their powerful trump cards that they had concealed for a long time. As a huge ancient family that had a vast accumulation of resources, it only needed to use a few of these trump cards to destroy a major faction. Nonplussed, Mr. Fang looked at them and said, I don't know how to phrase some words, and I wonder what you will think of them. Beside him, Li Lanruo lowered her head to slowly sip milk tea without a word. Obviously, she didn't know what to say. She kept her face lowered. She almost buried it under the couch. It seemed like she was afraid that she had misspoken and caused trouble. Sir, you don't have to hide your fear from us. Miu King seemed eager to see Mr. Fang act soft. After all, she could only obtain some satisfaction with words since she couldn't defeat him in the game. Why would I be afraid? Mr. Fang said, I just want to know what you think of the option of live stream. If you guys can also live stream. On Mr. Fang's system interface, a new task appeared. New task. Establishing dominance is required to keep a foothold. 2. Task description. Please establish dominance again so that the players in the shop can get online without worrying. No restrictions on methods that can be used. Task completion. Upon completing this task, it will show that the host has become a qualified internet cafe owner and can unlock more privileges. Task reward, fortune prize wheel, increase of privileges, unlocking of QQ Esports and QQ Live Stream. Customers can watch the live stream by downloading QQ on their communication jades. The members of the shop can download it without charge. We can live stream too? Jiangxi Oyu almost jumped up with surprise and joy. She had been in the shop for a long time and could only watch Mr. Fang live stream while feeling envious. I can live stream as well? She didn't know how Mr. Fang did the outdoor live stream, but it would be awesome to show her excellent strategies and gameplay to others even from inside the shop. After all, Mr. Fang had been showing off his skills every day and Jiangxi Oyu could do nothing but watch. Ugh. The others exchanged a look and said in pleasant surprise, "Can we do it too, Dot?" Meanwhile, in the heaven-seeking sword palace dash, deep beneath the gloomy sword tomb, there was no light. It was as black as hell. With a gloomy low growl, a dark red light suddenly flashed from the depths of the underground. Among the sounds of metal chains dragging on the ground and inhuman deep growls, groups of people in chains, young and old, kneeled on the ground as if they were worshipping their god. The broken ancient tombs looked like the residences of dominating gods or fierce, man-eating devils. While the gloomy and dark lights jumped, the lights in these people's eyes also moved. The ominous and gloomy growls struck fear into people's minds and sent chills down their spines. It was an ancient and powerful sword spirit which had existed for endless years but had never been eroded by time. The sword spirit inside the broken sword seemed more terrifying than the darkness in the deep abyss. The ancient engravings and sword slash marks on the tombstones were almost ground away by time, and all of this seemed to be telling a glorious story in the distant past. The dark lights lit up, and in the tombs laid ancient-looking long swords. Some of the swords were so rusted that it was hard to imagine their original looks, and some were covered by all kinds of ugly and vicious cuts from other weapons in battles, looking as if they would shatter in the next moment. However, no one dared to ignore the horrid, crazy, and demon-like sword spirits contained in the swords. Only one thread of this maniac sword spirit could induce the deepest fear in people's minds. Do you feel that? Wild laughter came from the great hall of the heaven-seeking sword palace. It sounded so arrogant as if everything in the world were under its feet and beneath it. Perhaps soon, everything in the world would indeed be beneath its feet and could no longer be in its eyes. Because, crack, a pitch black thunderbolt crashed down, and a black sword energy shot up from beneath the sword tomb. I wonder which ancestral master is coming out. Greetings, ancestral master. We all welcome your arrival. All the disciples of the heaven-seeking sword palace including Nangong Lin fell on their knees. Chapter 480, a netizen meetup. Are the Taoist tokens issued? In the black winds, Nangong Lin's slightly withered face oozed cold murderous spirit. When the godly swords in the sword tomb that were guarded by the heaven-seeking sword palace for generations came out, it was natural for the palace to invite the ancient families to attend and watch the ceremony. It was an opportunity for the heaven-seeking sword palace to show off their dominant strength to the world. By that time, Heaven-Seeking Sword Palace would remove all the obstacles before them and make all the forces in the spiritual state submit to this almighty sword power. Before Nangong Lin were about 100 prisoners in ragged clothes bound by black chains. Some of them were enemies of the Heaven-Seeking Sword Palace, some of them were traitors, and some of them were zealous followers. After being immersed in the horrid sword spirit in the sword tomb for many years, they had been transformed into half-human half-ghost sword slaves who could do nothing but follow orders. The other ancient families had thought that this was the biggest trump card of the heaven-seeking sword palace since the ancient times. If they had seen the godly sword that was engulfed in so much murderous spirit which ordinary people wouldn't even have the will to resist, they would have gathered all their forces and destroyed such a threat. However, it was too late now. Now that the Saint Ancestral Master has awakened, it is our Heaven-Seeking Sword Palace's turn to rule the world. In the sky, heavenly thunder rumbled, and the scarlet lightning bolts danced wildly, illuminating Nan Gonglin's face, which looked half ghost and half god. In this world, people hadn't heard about immortals for a long, long time. The strengths of the ancient families had gradually weakened as time went by, even though they were still stronger than the major families. These families once had many talented cultivators like water surging from a spring, but the cultivators of great talents were few and scarce in the past 1,000 years. It seemed to be a curse that no one could break. Perhaps after many years, these ancient families would disappear in the long river of time themselves. But now, only my heaven-seeking sword palace has the right to control this boat of the turbid mortal world. This dream will be realized in my hand. Roar! With an earth-shaking roar, the overwhelming murderous spirit which had turned into the sun-blocking dark clouds poured down like ocean waves. In the center of the murderous spirit was a sword in its infancy. Now that the Saint Ancestral Master is out, these sword slaves are useless. Take them down as sacrifices, Nan Gonglin said in a booming voice. Pass my order and hold a 7-day sword sacrificial ceremony. When the sacrificial ceremony ends and the ancient families gather here, our heaven-seeking sword palace will become the ruler of the world. After all, there was no one close to the realm of ascendance among the ancient families, let alone realm immortals. In Nan Gonglin's eyes, it was a piece of cake to deter and conquer them. What the heaven-seeking sword palace needed to do was strike fear into them by killing someone. Guys, why do you think many humans in the games look like Western barbarians? Puzzled, Xuanhuan even created a group to discuss this topic. The Western barbarians were the savages living in the region to the far northwest. Most of them were descendants of the native barbarians, and a few were refugees from the spiritual state. These people had fled there for many reasons. They might have fled from wars between big families, since these wars often caused slaughters of whole families. They might have fled from other catastrophes caused by humans or nature. A vast wasteland lay to the west of the spiritual state. Its harsh environment made it impossible for life except for the fierce beasts which had survived since the prehistoric times. Even the immature fierce beasts were as strong as grand ancestral warriors or even king warriors. It must be noted that the general strength of the warriors of the spiritual state was much greater than those in the deserted sea realm, even if they were on the same realm. It was a result of the living environment for warriors. Their warriors who had survived in this environment were not as weak as those in the deserted sea realm, even though they were still weaker compared to cultivators later on. The residents in the wasteland in the northwest were mainly warriors who had toughened their physical bodies in their fights with fierce beasts. They had their own fighting styles, which was different from the warriors living in the spiritual state. Elder Yu asked, maybe, according to the legends among the barbarians, they had experienced a period of prosperity in the past. I wonder if this stuff is something that the barbarians left from the prehistoric times? The black-robed Daoist Zumo chimed in. That's impossible. These guns and cannons are totally different from their weapons. I don't believe that they could have left such things. I would be shocked if their inheritance got twisted like this, Feng Yang Tsai said. I brought this question to the Taoist friends from other shops, and they said the cultivators and warriors who share our style have similar features as ours. However, the ordinary people who fight with such spiritual artifacts all look like the Western barbarians. The people in StarCraft all live on stars, right? Xuanhuan wondered, is it possible? He looked up at the ceiling as if he could see the sky through it. Maybe these people fell from the sky in the prehistoric times? Don't they say that there is something called gravity in the stars? Maybe one day this gravity disappeared, and they just fell from the stars. Fortunately, Mr. Fang wasn't in this group. Otherwise, he would bow to these people's great imagination and logical reasoning. I heard that the warriors from the northwest would come to the Heavenly Academy to have practice matches and discussions of martial Tao with us, right? Zemo replied, they only dare to fight with our warriors. If they dare to fight cultivators, many people can crush them. Boping spiritual master refuted, it's an exchange of martial Tao. It would be a shame if we sent cultivators to fight them. Xuanhuan said, Although our Heavenly Academy had Emperor Warriors before, I'm afraid that we might not be able to rival the barbarians in the Northwest. Alas, when I talked about the martial Dao with that old Nalan Hongwu in the group chat, I found that their understanding of martial Dao is very deep there. Heavenly Sword and Sword 23 are indeed powerful. Zumo added, we must watch the Wind and Cloud more often. Didn't they say that the second season has been released? There's someone named Li Shitan who is claimed to be even more powerful than the figures in the previous season. He looks powerful but hasn't revealed his true strength yet. I wonder how he is compared with Sword Sent and No Name, Zongwu said. I would be exhilarated if I could understand it by watching. I wonder how lucky the old Nalan Hongwu was that he was able to comprehend all of this. I'm totally clueless right now, Zumo said. Worst come to worst, we can invite them here and do a United Martial Dao discussion conference. I don't believe that those barbarians can defeat all of us. Boping Spiritual Master replied, shame on you! It would be a disgrace for us if we couldn't defeat them, and you want to further disgrace us by enlisting help from the deserted Sea Realm? But inviting them to a United Martial Dao discussion conference is not bad. The young people can have practice matches with each other. People from the deserted Sea Realm. I'm not sure if it's a good idea. Zongwu seemed to have remembered a taboo that existed only in the legends.